Do you realize that when the words people use indicate that there is a problem? There is one word which is, I did not count it, but the word interact was this afternoon, was used something like 50 times. And the other word which was used sort of 40 times was we created. And when everybody's talking about interaction or with about creation, that may mean you don't need to be the philosopher Wittgenstein to know that there is a problem. I mean, you start to talk about interaction when it's not a matter of fact anymore, and you talk about creation when it's not a matter of fact, when it's. I mean, it's very nice what you did, but by the way, I have been with so many students in my life. There are no bad students. There are only bad teachers. I mean, I'm not saying that here are bad teachers. I mean, this is an impossible assignment. Right? This two blocks and then try to connect and things. If I would do this assignment, I would say leave one block, I don't know, we are going to put it for rent or something, and try to do it in one block. That's already difficult enough. Mm-hmm. And all these people that made enormous pipes like Fanella, I mean, it's so expensive, it's so completely out of any realism. It's sort of pitfall to work in that way. And really, I was already saying that, but to become an architect is today is going to be really, well, I'm not saying painful, but it's
not easy.
Not easy. And what you should learn is also to make a presentation and to present something, you must be completely convinced of what you're saying, and you must not have your hand in your pocket, because you're not a cowboy. And, I mean, you're lost. I mean, we do competitions every week, in order to get a new job, and we sometimes we win, but most of them we don't win, and it is so, people are so looking at, is this the architect I want to work with? They're not looking at the architects. By the way, there was not one word, one thing of architecture on the floor this afternoon. It was, and that's okay. I don't want to talk about architecture. I just want to talk about space organization. And there was a lot of space organization to be explained. But, the French say it's c'est le ton qui fait la musique. It's how you say things to make believe what you're doing, what words you choose. It's very important to think of presentation. So today, an architect really must have, I say it again, must have ideas. I mean, I have heard some ideas. They don't need to be completely new because you are students. But, well, by the way, actually the real new ideas should come from students. But that's just by the way. But the idea to open up the building for other people to come to work there, that brings in money and brings in what was the word you used all the time?
Interaction.
Interaction. And what you were talking about the zoo at a certain moment. I mean, you consider this too much as a zoo, like these are special people, and this floor is open for the public, for the others, for interaction with the city. I mean, it's a sort of jargon. What do you mean with it? I mean, we have no time, and that's what I regret. But when somebody says, yes, we have interaction with the public or interaction with the city, I would jump up and say, what do you mean with that? What is that interaction with the what is that? Can you tell me what it is? I mean, the point is that you are right, but it's just abstract. It doesn't say anything. I mean, when you start saying we are going to rent out spaces or computers or we offer a sort of nice atmosphere where people can be together, can have some nice drinks, and can, as you say, learn from each other. That's all right, you know. It's not wrong, yeah. And that different professions come in. I wouldn't say we are the professionals and the flaps can come in and can we can learn them. I mean, it should be equality, you know, whether you have somebody who earns his money with putting pavement in the street, or somebody else who puts pavement in a sort of abstract science. We should consider this as equal, you know. And I feel in the tone, in the way you are discussing, that students are somewhere higher up, and they give the honor to the other people that they come in on. No, not on the second floor. No, that's forbidden. Only on the first floor. You know, it's a sort of ridiculous abstraction. And what I consider ideas, so which merit the word creation, is that how do you do that? How can you in terms of space organization, I mean, there's also of course organization in finances and in all sorts of things, that but we are architects, so how can you do that in terms of space organization, sort of seduce the people to come in and to say, okay, here I have to be here because this is the place where that's our work, I think. Yeah? And then without opportunism, because today it's terrible, architects are just selling themselves out completely just to get, well, another job, you know. They do everything what clients ask, even when these clients don't know about what they're doing. I'm fighting in my office the whole day against programs that say, you should not do this, you should not do that. Whereas I know that you should do that because it's better. Who am I, you know? But then to not become sort of opportunistic and say, okay, I do it because they say it. When you really want to consider architecture as a sort of science, then you know, you must really think and say, in what way can we do that? And then without pipes and enormous walls of glass, because you don't need that wall of glass. It was a good, I don't know who did that, this idea of this in between space. You don't need a wall of glass before. But it's a good idea to make that space, and then offer sort of surfaces. I say coffee, but or computers. It doesn't need to be coffee or computer, but offer something which is interesting for the other people, and then interaction becomes something completely obvious. Well, I could go on, but it's not here. Yeah? Okay. I agree a little bit.
Am I?
Agreeing a little bit.
Yeah, I definitely. I think one of the most interesting things you said is it's better to have a good idea than a complete floor plan filled up with rooms. So for them, it's really about thinking about your concept and also how you present it. So that you really convince somebody that it's just not about the word into acting, but what does it mean? What does it embody?
Make people believe that you are, that they can trust you and think, well, this people we can work together,
yeah.
You know. They say there is a chemistry in between
exactly.
People.
And that's what you're looking for when you design something, this chemistry between you and the client, you and the building, the ideas, it all comes together there. And another thing, and that's what I basically tell them from day one, is don't talk about I want to design. That's really speaking for myself, but like Herman said, really try to get into the minds of the people you're designing for.
Absolutely.
That's the only way that you can really
Absolutely.
Know what you're doing.
Empathy. The word, what empathy?
Empathy. Exactly. And
that you're not just make the usual trip of program here at the toilet. Here is this. Is this. But that you try to put yourself in place of the people you're supposed to work for and to work with. And that is mostly very poorly developed with architects.
Definitely.
And it should have, it should
especially
be
now
especially
now
developed, you know. My father has been a medical doctor, you know, and a medical doctor is supposed to see when you come in, there's something wrong with his toes. You know, see that in your eyes. I mean, it's a sort of intuition. And you really must learn to. I mean, that's a very important part of learning, to understand what others have in mind and what others want and not want. And so on. Otherwise, you are ending up in a zoo. Is exactly the right word for it. You know, it's sort of zoo, like you don't quite know, but the apes react. You don't know why the apes or the giraffes react, but oh, they react. Yes, okay, we are on the right. the penguins. You know, they have the most fantastic penguin houses made by Lubetkin in London. But he didn't ask the penguins what they wanted, you know, because it's difficult because you don't understand the language of the penguins. But they hip on it, so you think, oh, they are happy, you know, because they use it. And we must really stop to consider our the people who are our clients as penguins. You know, you can't do that as animals. We must really just step ahead and be one of this people and then say, okay, when I'm in this position, I want to say to my architect that and that. And then you are standing, you know, you must be the two persons at the same time. I think that's an important lesson for the for an academy of today.
Well, they are pre-academy students. They are still in the HBO period, so they are finishing their HBO study, their bachelor's, and then after that they will go towards
the academy. So
there's hope. There's hope, yes. We're on time.
And maybe there's something that The one thing I liked most today, what I saw, was there was one group that had sort of a mini idea in the whole thing. And that was an idea, somebody spoke from their own experience and said, you know what it's like, you work here, and then we wish we had a place to sleep here. And I think that is a nice... that was your presentation. Okay. What I like about it is that you turn it around. You don't say, oh, we need places to sleep, and then how do we make them study? No, you say... It's a place to study, and I can imagine if you start from that point of view, that you say the whole building, there's no space to sleep. What would happen? Because then they have no beds. Are they going to out of themselves ask for complete bedrooms, you know, with mini kitchens in it? Or would they ask for a couch that can fold into a bed, because that's a lot more nice, because you sleep over, you know? It's more like a pajama party feeling then. I don't know if that's the word, you know, then this sort of, oh, I have my own lounge feeling. Just because you can doesn't mean you should. And I think the biggest danger of the presentations today is that you're filling in grids. You know, you have this grid, we have to put things in there. What are the functions? Well, there they go. But I would just start with the experience. Like, what in your opinion is the essence of when you were learning the most, when you were really excited about your own ideas and other people's ideas? Go back to that feeling and then think, where does sleeping come in and where does eating come in? And if you design from that point of view, from the experience itself, I think you'll get a lot more interesting concepts going on.
Yep.